In this video, I want to show another form of current divider equation, and then just an example how you can use this different form than what we saw in an earlier lecture. So here we have our current flowing into two parallel resistors, and the current through R1 is IR1, and the current through R2 is IR2. And then here is the current divider equation based on the form we've already talked about, that the current through R1 is going to be the current flowing into the parallel combination times a ratio of resistances, Req of the parallel resistors in the numerator, and the value of the resistor we want the current for in the denominator. And then likewise, here's the current divider equation for R2, same current out front, same Req in the numerator, but then R2 in the denominator because that's the current we want the resistor for. And then here's our Req for parallel resistors, two parallel resistors, product over sum, that we talked about in the topic video right before this video. So this alternative form of current divider equation is just taking this product over sum expression for Req and plugging it in the numerator of this expression for current divider that we had previously. So you see, if for the top equation for IR1, okay, if I put in product over sum here, the R1 down here cancels out the R1 in the numerator of the Req expression. So I would now have this equation here. It would be I times R2, right, since the R1 canceled out, over R1 plus R2. Okay, and then here for IR2, the current through R2, if I plug in Req, well, the R2 will cancel out, and I'll have the current out front times this here. Okay, so you see in this form of current divider, if you want the current through R1, okay, you want the current through R1, well, in the ratio, the numerator is R2, denominator is the sum of the two resistors. And then if you want the current through R2, well, you put R1's value in the numerator and it's still the sum of the resistors in the denominator. So this is just another form of current divider equation. You can see it comes from the form that we had earlier, but you just make this substitution with product over sum for your Req. So you know, it's important to remember that this form of current divider will only work if you're looking at two resistors in parallel. The expression we had last time, you know, the first current divider expression that we looked at, that will work no matter how many resistors you have in parallel. However, you can use this form on multiple resistors in parallel. It's just you have to use it multiple times. So as an example of what I'm talking about, let's say we have this example here where we have a 9 amp current source and three resistors in parallel, value 2 ohms, 6 ohms, and 12 ohms, and we want to find the current through this 12 ohm. Well, the first thing we would have to do in order to use this new form, you know, this alternative form of current divider equation, is we would have to get the circuit down into two parallel resistors. So one way I could do that, I would just leave this 2 ohm the same value, but now do a reduction, reduce these two parallel resistors into one parallel resistor. And you know, you could do sum of reciprocals reciprocated or product over sum. And product over sum, you would get that you have 72, okay, 6 times 12 over 18, 6 plus 12, okay, which is 4. Okay, so that would be the value of the 6 See, this 4 came from the 6 in parallel with the 12. Okay, that's my notation for parallel, shorthand notation. So now I could find the current through the 4 ohm. Okay, using current divider equation in the form that we just came up with during this lecture, where the 9 would be the current in front of the ratio. And then in the numerator would go the value of the other resistor. See, I want the current through the 4 ohm, but the other resistor value goes in the numerator. Okay, so I would put the 2 here. And then the denominator would just be the sum of the two resistors. Okay, so you can see 1/3. So we would have 1/3, we'd have 3 amps. Alright, so you see the current through that 4 ohm resistor would be 3 amps, right? Meaning there's 6 amps through this 2 ohm. So now, if I want to get the current for this 12 ohm resistor, see, since I found that there's 3 amps through the 4 ohm in this diagram, and that 4 came from the 6 and 12 in parallel, that means up here, flowing into that parallel combination of the 6 and 12 is 3 amps. Okay? So now I would apply current divider equation a second time to this parallel combination where the current flowing in is 3 amps. So I, the current that we're after, okay, current I, that would equal 3 we want the current through the 12, so the other resistor would go in the numerator, so the 6 would go in the numerator. And then 6 plus 12 would be in the denominator, so 6 over 18, 1/3 times 3, 1 amp. That's what our answer would be. Okay? So this is just another way you can do the problem. See, if we just used the first expression for current divider that we got earlier in the earlier video, we would just do it in one equation. We would just have that the current I is equal to 9, okay, times Req of the parallel resistors divided by 12, okay. And Req of the parallel resistors, well, we'd have 4 in parallel with 2. That would be the overall Req of the three resistors. So using product over sum, 4 times 2 is 8, divided by 4 plus 2, which is 6. So this would be 9, I think it would be 8, divided by 6, and then divided by 12. So you bring this 12 up, 12 times 6, 72, 9 over 72 is 1/8, and you'd have 8 over 8, which is 1 amp. Okay, so you see, same answer, you know, with the original current divider expression we did in the previous video, you know, it just takes one equation. Using this new form of the current divider equation, where you have to look at, or you have to analyze the circuit two parallel resistors at a time, you know, it took more steps. Why do I bring this up? Well, you're bound to see both forms of current divider equation, and really it's just personal preference which one you use and when you use it. Personally, I use the expression for the two resistors just if I have a circuit with two resistors, but if I've got more than that, then I'll use this expression because you can just do it in one equation. But it's really just personal preference.